Horrible weather has overshadowed the coast of Demak, Central Java, Indonesia. Heavy rain and strong winds have been going on for several days. Pasija can only do activities in her house. She has been unable to plant mangroves in the last 3 months.
Nah, tahun wingi-wingi to Mas, cuaca ngene iki to rada mending lah. Biasanya cuma sebulan lah. Paling suwe 2 bulan. Iki kok ngantek 3 bulan nih. Cuacane iki parah iki. Rasa kok tahun wingi-wingi. Semakin tambah panasnya yo berkurang lah. Nggak anginnya teko terus kok ini. Jadi ini ki panasnya be anu ini ki akeh cuacane ki mas akeh gitu. Anginnya be ngombyake. Sing tahun iki.
Pasija is a little worried about her children, who haven't returned home. She hoped the rain and wind would subside a little. In average weather, it only takes 10 minutes from the mainland to her house by boat.
Aku iki to Mas, asale koncone ya akeh, tonggo-tonggo. Wong 200 kakak iki lebih. Lah berhubung aku ncen ra melu pindahan kono wis iki wis sak keluarga ning kene dhewe sak keluarga, anak telu, Pak, Mbek, Mak, dadese 5. Keluarga nih. Wis pokoke tak niati ning kene. Ora pindah. Aku ning kene yo jeh anu Mas, yo jeh. Darat lah, ijeh ana pari anu tani. Ning kene. Aku ning kene awak 2000 pira ya. Ning kene 32 Mas. 32 berarti pirang taun ya. Ya jaman mau ya tani Mas wong aku ya. Buru-buru tandur lah. Jupro-jupro golek iwak lah apalah wis awet cilik kangelan dhewe.
In 1990, Pasija's home was 2.5 kilometers from the shoreline. But by now, seawater had overtaken Pasija's house up to 5 kilometers inland, isolating Pasija and her family from the mainland.
Saawit tahun 2000 kuwi, 2000-ji. Rope kan wis masuk sithik-sithik-sithik ta Mas, terus kok tambah, terus asale yo pari kala wujud segala opo no tani, lah kok tahun 2000-ji iki kok mulai repok sengko sithik-sithik tambah terus ora ana kendhate. Terus tahun 2005 kuwi do jeluk rasa. Rope kan semakin tambah daleane ilang. Yuk rasa kecamatan diparingi. Bar diparingi kuwi mau terus dibagi bar dibagi do lunga sithik-sithik. Sithik-sithik mape entek 2010. Aku ning kene dhewe langsung spring iki.
Seawater completely submerged the Rejosari Senik sub-village, Bedono, Demak, in 2005. Seawater has become a new neighbor for Pasija and her family. However, unlike their previous neighbors, seawater is often not friendly.
Omah iki kendalane iki ombak gedhe. Nak ombak, kalau nak turu bantalan ombak. Blek. Ya ki sing sebelah ajir. Entek ngunggahin ki peng
tahun piro mawon?
Peng papat iki. Pokoke awet tahun tahun piro ya? Tahun 5 ki tak unggahke. Terus tahun 10. Terus tahun 12-an. Terus diingi ki tahun piro ya, Nang? Iki 6B Mas, nggih 2 tahunan iki. Terus iki.
Adaptation is the only way for her to survive. The weather on the coast continues to get worse from year to year. Elevating the house is not the best solution for the Pasija's family. She has built a natural fort by planting mangroves to protect her home.
Tahun 2000, kalau mulai nandur, wis arep mlebu sithik-sithik to. Kalau mulai nandur sisa-sisa rumah kok dewe-dewe spring. Sale dolan yang murah demek ono bibitan kido tiba tak ditili tak tandur ke sebelah sebelah gitu kok alhamdulillah iso urep lah terusan itu terusan sing do gede dowo terus tak undui terus langsung pelatihan bibit wi alhamdulillah dowo seprene alhamdulillah ditunggasi cah kuliah wartawan mahasiswa
iki apa arep anu mas masang bambu iki lho kanggo mangkruk ning tambak elek kok dari ngadang-ngadangi lah bisane aman mangkruke bisane bener bisane aman di fisik.
Pasija and her family's struggle to plant mangroves has shown promising results. Her home has withstood the brutal waves and winds for the last 20 years. In 2015, Pasija succeeded in growing mangroves covering an area of more than 74 hectares. Not only protecting her house from the brunt of the sea waves and wind, but the mangrove forest has also become a new home for thousands of birds.
Ini dhisik Mas, asline tanah apik sawah. Tanah yo ki manggon omah-omah iki Mas. Lah sing sebelah tanduri pari. Pari ambek ang jangan-jangan kalau ijo itu ya tomat, lombok, ya telo, ya pugung. Pokoke ya klopo, segala apa ana Mas. Asline ndek kae. Ya terus berhubung kuwi awet tahun 2001 terus mulai rob. Kalau wijone ambek wit-witane utama dua mati. Kena banyu asin kan ratahan banyu asin. Lah terus dua mati, terus tak ganti mangrove iki. Lah berhubung iki wis tukul apik, wis gedhe-gedhe. Mandar abrasine semakin kenceng. Ketera ombak sithik-sithik, gelombange kan akare to Mas, goyang-goyang. Akhire ketera angin jengkar. Lah anak ancen tanggul iki Mas dipimpin di rumati permenta ya alhamdulillah iso bisa tanduri mana iso apik mana mangrupe iso urip mana jadi ini kan permenta nak tanggul ini kan rada aman omahku berang aman mangrupe aman ya nak berhubung rada rumat yuk ya entek toh engko dek sedurunge dadi iki wis tekan sido gemek Mas sido gemek nggon pabrik kopi kuwi to Mas wis kelem kabeh dalane pancura omah-omah kelem tenan Mas iki untung ijo ana iki ombake ora patek tekan kono ora ana iki Mas ambles tekan kono ombake aku ora ngapusi.
The northern coastline is the national road which connects many essential cities on the island of Java. An average of 33,000 vehicles pass on this route every day. The threat of being drowned by seawater has been evident on this vital route. Regional planning and urban planning expert Mila Carmila assesses that climate change is not the only cause for the sinking of several areas in central Java, but also massive physical development and uncontrolled extraction of groundwater in the northern coastal regions of Java.
In Book of Mali Dadi Segoro, that we write, they have 37 industrial in long side of a coastal area from Semarang until Demak. So you can imagine how many labor that use the groundwater extraction. And the second is because the construction in the land, especially in the coastal area, is very massive, I think. They have many, that I said, they have 37 industrial. So this is the cause of the abrasion too. Maybe our government already ratified or signed about the ratification of Protocol Kyoto or other Paris Agreement like that. But the implementation of all of the regulation or all of the what is it ratified that they have signed, I don't think is have implementation in coastal area because maybe you already seen the land subsidence in Semarang is almost 11 11 cm per year. So if they implementation the protocol Kyoto, maybe the land subsidence cannot down until 11 cm per year. Like Ibu Pasija or maybe Timbos Loko resident, they know the situation and they still have hope that government give a program, but they know too that government is sometimes give a good program, so they only can adaptation with the situation, coping with the situation, adaptation with the situation. Maybe if the government have a good solution, like they construct a dike construction, and then after the adaptation, they have already have protection, so the people can live like they before they sink in the water.